Hi guys, my name is Michelle Ford. I'm here at the Northeast Film Festival with the creative team of Erosion Now, which just screened in the last block here at the Northeast Film Festival. So guys, tell me a little bit about how it feels to have this audience reaction from your film.
It was a lot of fun to see it on the big screen and to hear the audience reacting to it. Yeah. And it's always nice to see yourself that big.
Yeah, definitely. Why don't you tell me a little bit about the film, first of all, for our
Yeah, so this is a personal story of a woman going through a breakup, and what was really nice was when we wrote it and filmed it, we left it very open to interpretation, and that was what the audience were feeling tonight. They were asking, you know, is it about this? What does this represent? And I'm like, it's all whatever you want it to represent.
That's
so
great.
It's great. Every festival, people have different reactions. So
wonderful. Is this your guys' first time at NEF?
I had a film actually that was here last year, a film called Deadbeat that I directed and produced. And actually, I think the writer and executive producer of Deadbeat has another film that's in the festival this year, Selfish Ones, Eric Crisanti.
Yeah.
Yeah, we saw that at Soho. It was great.
Wonderful. So you talked a little bit about the film being sort of open to interpretation. Is there maybe like a central message that you want to make sure the audience takes away from the film when they screen it?
A central message? Gosh. I mean, for me as the writer-director, I would say I would love people to take away from it to know that they're worth more than what they think they're worth when they go through something tragic. The film really focuses on a woman feeling kind of worthless. So, yeah. I don't know. As an actor, what do you reckon?
I think that one of the things that Kat mentioned and that I think is really important is the fact that people can interpret it how they will and can identify something in it that is personal to them. So I think while we have our own ideas about, you know, a message, you know, the metaphors within it, the fact that people have been connecting with it so personally and saying, oh, well, this is what it felt to me because of my personal experience, I think that's the best part of seeing it and hearing how people react to it.
Absolutely. Why don't you tell me a little bit about your preparation process as an actor?
Well, so I was also producing in addition to acting.
Multiple hats.
Yes, multiple hats.
It's a little different.
It's pretty standard for indie filmmaking, which definitely made it a little difficult. However, I sort of subscribe to the school of acting that, like, if the words are on the page and you've done your homework in terms of the character background, then you're just going to be able to feel it and be it.
Yeah.
And I'm not a method actor. I don't need to be in character 24/7. So I can walk on set, give myself, you know, 20 minutes to get into character, and then I'm there. So for me, that's fine, and I don't need a tremendous amount of preparation other than just being very, very, very familiar with the script and whatever the story there is behind it.
It also helped that as the producer, he was involved from like day one and every draft of the script, you know. So that also really helped. Like, his character development was happening in real time with him, and. Yeah.
Yeah. And how did you guys come together to collaborate?
We've worked on a lot of film projects together, but we met like 7 or 8 years ago working on a feature, and ever since then we've continued to work on projects together in various capacities as producers, ADs, directors, actors.
Yeah.
We just acted in a short together back in June.
Amazing.
It's fun to collaborate.
I know that once you spend enough time with people, with the same crew, you develop a chemistry and things come a lot more naturally, and that's, and you're on the same page in terms of artistic, you know, fulfillment and things like that. So, hi. We didn't even get to introduce this little guy. Hi. We had a few little stars in our interviews today.
This is Nikki.
Hi, buddy.
Yeah.
Hi. Oh, look.
And he also has already starred in a movie.
In utero.
Wow.
in utero, and he's gotten to be.
So this is your second feature. Oh, already a little star. Yeah. Well, thank you guys so much for taking the time to speak with me.
You.
It was so nice meeting you. Congratulations on your screening today.
We're super excited because we're up for a Best Director as well. So it'll be really fun tomorrow night.
Yes,
yeah.
Amazing. I will be there cheering you on, and best of luck to you.
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks.